Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank you for tuning in to Rhema Word Ministries, where we're changing lives one day at a time. We want to thank God for those of you who are viewing in today via Facebook and social media. I have a word today brought to you by the Holy Ghost. Let's start off with the word of God in prayer. Father, right now, we thank you right now. We thank you right now, Father God, for keeping us in this time. We thank you right now, Father God, for the listeners, Father God, that's viewing in via Facebook, Father. And we pray right now, Father God, you would touch them. Give them a word that will bring new life. And right now, Father God, I pray as I decrease that you increase in me. Less of me and more of you. None of me and all of you. And I declare right now, Father God, as I sit in you, you stand in me. That's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Listen, the word of God for today is found in Matthew chapter 20. Matthew chapter 20, verse 29 through 34. Matthew 20, verses 29 through 34. Verses 29 says, Matthew 20 and 29. Now as they went out of Jericho, a great multitude followed him. And behold, two blind men sitting by the road, when they heard that Jesus was passing by, cried out, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, Son of David." And the multitudes warned them that they should be quiet. But they cried out even the more, saying, "Have mercy on us, O Lord, Son of David." And so Jesus stood still and called them and said, "What do you want me to do for you?" They said to him, "Lord, that our eyes may be open." So Jesus had compassion on them and touched their eyes. And immediately their eyes received sight. Here it is. And they followed him. Verse 29, you had two blind men sitting by the road, blind. Verse 34, after they got healed, and they followed him. I want to preach this morning as the Spirit leading God us from this thought in our mind. We will get through this together. Yeah, somebody ought to type that on the page this morning. We will get through this together. I declare, ladies and gentlemen, whatever we are going through today, that I believe we will get through this together. It won't be an isolated breakthrough, but I believe we will get through this together. That I believe when your husband get out, you will get out. That when your husband get through, you will get through. You won't get through it by yourself, but we will get through this together. That's my prayer, ladies and gentlemen. I don't want God to get me out and leave my members in. But I'm shouting today knowing that we will get through this thing together. If God brought us to it, he'll bring us through it. You all just typed it on the page this morning. We will get through this together. Oh, united we stand. We're going to get through this thing together. It hit all of us, but all of us are going to make it through this thing. And I declare this morning, you ought to hold your head up, hold your head back, and realize we're going to get through this together. Can get tight together. Here in the book of Matthew, ladies and gentlemen, Jesus, he was going through Jericho. Jericho was known as an unclean place. And Jesus began to do miracles, and Jesus went through Jericho. But while coming out of Jericho, Jesus found two blind men sitting by the road. And oftentimes, ladies and gentlemen, when you study history, you find out that those people who were blind, they often sat by the road to beg. Because of their condition, they did not have a job. And if they had one, they were considered to be unemployed. Because if they were blind, they could not work. And so now they are sitting by the road. And they was by the road the whole time begging. But little did they know that the season was begging was coming to an end. I don't know who I'm talking to this morning, who watching via Facebook, but God wanted me to let you know that your season of begging is getting ready to come to an end. Your season of unemployment is getting ready to come to an end. For those of you who had to close your business down, that season is getting ready to come to an end. For those of you who had to leave your job and you got downsized, now you are no longer working. You ought to hold your head up. Why? Because the season is getting ready to come to an end. And I know the government is getting ready to send us a stimulus check. But I give God praise because God is getting ready to send us a check. God is getting ready to bless you way more than what man could bless you. And if you give God praise, if you gave God praise based on what Trump did, I dare you to give God praise based on what God did. Because God is getting ready to do some stuff man can't even do. Just for the mere fact that you survived this pandemic. Just for the mere fact you didn't give up. You didn't throw in the towel. And I'm talking to somebody right now. You've been affected. You got the virus, but the virus don't have you. And even in the midst of it all, you still can give God praise. I dare you to praise him right now, knowing that God is a rewarder for them that diligently seek him. These two blind men, ladies and gentlemen, they were blind and they were sitting by the road begging. Sitting by the road begging, they were blind. Both of them were blind. Did not say that one were paralyzed and one was blind, but the Bible says here two blind men. It's two blind men. Both of them were in the same boat. Both of them had the same crisis. Both of them were going through the exact same thing. And ladies and gentlemen, all of us indirectly or directly been affected by this virus. And all of us are going through the exact same thing. But I'm here to let somebody know this morning that we will get through this together. Can you shout together? So the question is, Apostle Mac, how do we get through this together? The Bible says here, ladies and gentlemen, that these was two blind men. And the Bible says in verse 30, it says to us that they were sitting by the road. And while they were sitting by the road, ladies and gentlemen, verse 30 tells us that they heard Jesus was passing by. I want to park my car right there. Why? Because these two men in the same predicament, in the same exact crisis, going through the same thing, these men, the Bible says in verse 30, that they heard that Jesus was passing by. Notice what it didn't say. It didn't say that he heard that Jesus was passing by. No, the Bible says, and they heard that Jesus was passing by. Which suggests to me that both of them was listening to the same thing. Ooh, I can get happy. Both of them was listening to the same thing. You know how many people were talking around them? You know how many conversations they could have been engaged in? You know how many voices that were in their ear at that particular time? But both of them decided that if we're going to get through this together, we both had to listen to the same thing. They both of them, watch this, they gave an ear to the Christ and not the crisis. Let me say it one more time. They begin to listen to their Christ and not the crisis. In other words, if we are going to get through this together, both of us have to listen to the positive and not the negative. Yes, I know what the news is saying. I know what the critics are saying. I know the numbers on the screen. I know how many people got the virus. I know how many people got tested. But that's one thing. But if we are going to get through this, we have to listen to Christ and not our crisis. So if I'm going to listen to Christ, what did Christ tell me? He told me I was wounded for your transgressions. I was bruised for your iniquities, and the chastisement of peace was laid upon him, and by his stripes I am healed. He told me that he that dwells dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadows of the Almighty. He told me that when my mother and father forsake me, God will lift me up. He said, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. Why? Because God, he's with me. And I'm talking to somebody today. I don't care what you've been hearing. I don't care what you've been seeing. You got to learn how to listen to the voice of the Lord. What has God promised you lately? And in order, watch this, for our marriages to survive, ladies and gentlemen, both of us have to be listening to the same thing. We cannot be listening to our crisis. We have to listen to Christ. And when we listen to Christ, he said, what God has joined together shall no man put asunder. And I'm looking for two people here today who are watching via Facebook saying, you know what, we're going to listen to the same thing. I'm not listening to anything negative, but I gotta have the positive thing deposited in my spirit. So the Bible says that these two men, they heard Jesus was passing by. They gave an ear to the voice of the Lord, and nothing moved them but Jesus. It wasn't about the presence of people. It was about the presence of the Lord. And when Jesus showed up, he got their attention. And the Bible says they heard, what did they hear? They heard that Jesus was passing by. They heard that he was passing by. Notice, Jesus was getting ready to leave Jericho. And when he entered into Jericho, some kind of way they missed him. Some, maybe they wasn't paying attention. Maybe they didn't come to church that Sunday. Maybe they were doing something else. But when Jesus was getting ready to leave Jericho, they heard that he was passing by. In other words, they heard that he was leaning in their direction. And if he's passing by, you know, Big Mama said this, while thou art on others, please don't pass me by. And I believe if he did it for my neighbor, he'll do it for me. And so this particular time, now I know he's coming back in my direction. I'm going to make sure I'm in position for a breakthrough. I'm going to make sure I'm in position to receive what belongs to me. I probably missed it the first time, but I won't miss it again. I probably missed it the first time he came in. Oh, but now he's making a U-turn. And he's making a U-turn just for me. I'm talking to somebody. He's getting ready to turn around just for you, just for you, just for you. I know you have bills and you don't have money, but he's making a U-turn. I know your marriage is jacked up, but he's making a U-turn. I know you're going through a whole lot of stuff, but he's making a U-turn. And when he's turning around, he's turning your situation around. I believe he's turning this virus around. I believe he's turning this pandemic around. That when Jesus made a U-turn, these blind men was no longer blind, but they received their sight. So here, Jesus is coming by. Notice what they said. They said, Lord, watch this. Son of David, have mercy on us. Ooh. Notice, still here, verse 30, they yelled out, he's passing by, leaning in their direction. He's on his way. Watch this. And notice what they said. Right? They said, Son of David, watch this, have mercy on us. Now, we will get through this together. And watch this. Notice. One of them could have said, have mercy on me. He didn't say that. He said, have mercy on us. Now, mercy implies me receiving some stuff I don't deserve. Notice these men, they were in Jericho. And in Jericho, you had a lot of Gentiles, people that were considered to be unclean. And most people in biblical times who were blind, they were blind because of sin. Watch this. They were blind because of sin, which means they deserve to be blind. They did not deserve their sight. All right? They deserve to be blind. But now they see Jesus making a U-turn. They see Jesus leaning in their direction. They don't want to be in this situation for a long time, nor do they want to be in it the rest of their life. So they said, since he's in my proximity, notice they did not say, heal me. But the first thing they said was, have mercy on us, which suggests to me, I know I messed up. I know I dropped the ball. I know I'm unclean. But what I'm getting ready to ask you for are some stuff I don't deserve. And the reason why we ought to give God praise on this morning, because half of the stuff we have, we didn't deserve. You don't deserve the car you have in your driveway. You don't deserve the house you're living in. You don't deserve who you are married to. You don't deserve where you are living right now. But God, in times past, gave you some stuff you didn't deserve. And I believe on this Sunday morning, if we shout, have mercy, God is getting ready to stop and release a blessing on our lives. It's not about what we want, but it's what God wants for us. And these two men realize our life is jacked up. We are full of sin, but yet I need to be able to see. So when I see him, yes, I believe we're going to come out together. But what we need to have is not a house, not a new job, not a breakthrough. What we need is God's mercy. Can you type mercy? Can you type mercy? Can you type, God, have mercy? Have mercy on the United States. Have mercy on this world. Have mercy in this community. Have mercy on the people that's working in the hospital. Have mercy on the faculty and staff. Have mercy on the students. Have mercy on our children. Have mercy on the men. Later on for the house. Later on for the job. But I'm crying out for your mercy. And if I can have your mercy, I have a house. If I can have your mercy, I'll get my job back. If I can have your mercy, I'll be healed of this virus. If I can ask you first for your mercy. And the moment they asked Jesus, watch this, he was passing by. He was getting ready to leave. But when they yelled out, Son of David, have mercy, the Bible says, and he stood still. I believe today, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you yell out for mercy, healing will stand still in your house. The moment you yell out for mercy, what God has in store for you, it will not pass you by. The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name will humble themselves, and how do you humble yourself? You humble yourself by letting God know what I'm asking you for. I don't deserve this stuff, but I'm getting down on my knees to let you know, have mercy on me. What I'm asking you for, I don't even deserve it, and it's by your grace and your mercy. So they said and yelled out, have mercy. In order for us, ladies and gentlemen, to make it out together, number two, we need his mercy. When we humble ourselves, ladies and gentlemen, and beg for the mercy of God has given us some stuff we don't even deserve. And I'm talking to somebody this morning, the main thing you need is the main thing you don't deserve. But if we will humble ourselves and stop asking for the main stuff and begin to ask for the mercy of God. He asked for the mercy. And that's why they said, God, have mercy on us. Which entails all of us going through. All of us dropped the ball. All of us made mistakes. The Bible says in Romans, for all have sinned, come short of the glory of God. And in order for us, ladies and gentlemen, to make it through this pandemic, what the president must understand, what the preachers must understand, what this whole world must understand, what we need is your mercy. And if we can yell out for your mercy, I believe, as Jesus stood still, this virus will stand still. I believe, ladies and gentlemen, no longer will it begin to perpetuate and move forward. But this virus, ladies and gentlemen, it will soon stand still. So as I close, ladies and gentlemen, I'm letting you know, all of us will make it through this together. But in order for us to get through this together, you have to be hearing the same thing. And what are we hearing? We're hearing the instructions of the Lord. I know what the news is saying. I know what the media is putting out there. But in order for us to make it together, we have to have a united effort to listen and hear the voice of the Lord. And while hearing the voice of the Lord, if we're going to ask for anything, ladies and gentlemen, this morning, I need all of us as a whole, watching by Facebook, if we can say, Lord, have mercy on us. Notice, they didn't say, as we all say, have mercy on me. No. Because I don't want to get out by myself. I want all of us to get out together. And so I'm praying, Lord, have mercy on us. Thank you for tuning in. Listen, we are out of time, but we're not out of word. Please join us next week. By the way, those of you who are members of Rhema Word and those of you who would like to support us online, you can, if you would just follow the screen, rhemaword.net, you can sow online. You can also sow via Cash App. Yes, you can see it on top of the screen. But for those of you who do not like giving online, you can mail the donation to our church. The address is 900 39th Street North, Birmingham, Alabama, 35222. Have a blessed day and see you next week.